Hey everybody, welcome to Minne Moto Show, episode number 2. Today, we are going to talk about X Games predictions, 2020, Snow Bike Cross. I'm Jackie Riess.
I'm Haley Shanley.
And here we are, drinking wine.
Get your rear in gear, it's time for the Minne Moto Show.
Yeehaw.
I think we would be amiss not to address what had just happened.
What just happened?
We're in an Airbnb. And apparently we have neighbors downstairs, unbeknownst to us. The neighbors come up and knock on the door. It's, mind you, it's like 1 a.m. We're a little bit alarmed. And Moto Mom Angela, she answers the door, bless her heart. And they want to meet the Jackie Riess. And I don't know why I thought this was so funny, but Angela directs them to her website, JackieRiess.com. That's all. There's not really much of a climax to this story.
The end.
That's it.
Yep. The guy was in shock. She has her own website? Yes, I have my own website. It's not very incredible.
So as we speak, we're getting business cards printed with nothing other than JackieRiess.com printed on them. Mm-hmm. So
very explanatory. Very helpful.
So gentlemen, form a line, please, single file.
She only takes inquiries through her website.
We'll address you in the order in which things were received. So,
so that has nothing to do with that game, so.
Absolutely not.
No.
But a brilliant and graceful segue into X Games. Mm-hmm. You know, we just had practice today. We're going racing tomorrow. These boys and girls came there to raise hail and praise Dale.
Boys and girl.
That's what...
You said girls.
I did.
Just girl. Nice just catch. Colleen.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Colleen, she's good. She's racing the adaptive class. She raced it last year. She's the only woman to race snow bike cross in X Games. Only woman to do that. So, pump for her. And I hope she does well. She had a crash last year that prevented her from doing super well, but she got third at the qualifiers, so she's going to be good.
What a stud. Mm-hmm. I'm excited to watch her.
Me too.
But for practice today, we unfortunately have had a bit of a struggle trying to find live timing and some results from that. But we have some anonymous sources, some boots on the ground in Aspen.
Yes.
What have you got, Jackie?
IREF apparel? Very, very not anonymous anymore, but we know who's good, Haley, Cody, Cody Matichuk, our 2-time champ. He's going for a three-peat, which is incredible. Who else do we have?
And that's not a huge shocker. He's been pretty good here on the Amsoil Championship Snowcross circuit. Of course, looking for his 3-time. Gold medal.
Yeah.
Three-time gold.
Yeah.
Yeah, 3-time gold medal.
Yeah.
So not a huge surprise there. That's awesome to see. I hear Seth Fisher also looking pretty smooth, as well as Darren Meese.
Yeah. Seth won the first qualifier in Snowmass. They split it into 2 days. So he won the very first qualifier by, I think it was 30 seconds. Let me look at my notes here. 15. Okay. Still like... a solid lead. He won by a long shot on a very small track that was about 45 seconds. So that's incredible. I mean, the kid works hard. We did a fundraiser together. We're kind of in the same boat of like, hey, we're broke, but we're going to go racing. So I really hope this is his breakout year. And, you know, he got fifth last year, a very quiet fifth. And, I think he'll be good. He'll be solid.
We'd love to see it. A collective Wattentar nation. Showtime. It's practice. It means nothing.
No.
There's no prize for winning hot laps. But we're hearing Jesse perhaps wasn't feeling the best today. Was feeling uncomfortable, I guess. Which is pretty uncharacteristic of the kid.
Yeah, I don't know if he's nervous or how he's feeling. But, you know, last year he got out to an early lead in the race. And he led for quite a bit of the race. And at that point in time, that was really his first taste of winning and of running with those top guys and beating those top guys. And now, you know, he came back from X Games. He raced the Amsoil Snowcross Series. And he won 9 straight. And that's incredible, really. Like, the kid has some confidence. I don't know if it's getting to his head right now, but I don't think it should. Like, if he just lets it go, he'll be good. He'll be one to contend for this title. And, you know, we kind of split this into groups about what we're going to talk about. And our top three podium guys are really, like, the favorites. Cody, who is going for his three-peat, and the cowboy, Jesse Kirschmeyer. You know, that kid, he won the series last year, the AMSL Snowcross Series. And Brock Hoyer, mm-hmm. who we haven't mentioned yet, but he won the inaugural Snow BikeCross X Games. So now I believe he was bronze last year, and, you know, we'll see what he's got. From what we hear from our sources, took him a little bit to warm up today, but he warmed up. And, you know, the track is tough from what we hear. It's real sendy. You gotta hit some big jumps. And you know who's sendy?
Who's that?
Mike Schultz.
No
Monster
doubt.
Mike Schultz. Mm-hmm. Quote, 80% sendier than the pro class.
I like
Mike's,
that.
Mike's just racing the adaptive class. But he's going for it. I saw a picture of him today. He's like way up in the air hitting jumps I wouldn't even hit on my dirt bike. So, you know, good for him. Really good for him. And I think it's awesome that he gets to come to X Games and compete in so many different disciplines. Like he won the adaptive, or I don't know. They call it, but the adaptive snowboard.
Mm-hmm.
Sorry for blanking on the name, not knowing the name. But he won that yesterday, so that's super awesome for him. Like, I bet he's having so much fun just going, and he really is an ambassador for all of these sports. And he has his company,
BioAdapt.
He has his company BioAdapt, and you know he really helps all these athletes develop accommodations to help them be where they once were. So that's super cool for him, and he really is awesome.
He really is. He's the people's champ. Everyone wants to see the guy do well. Not only is he sendier than a lot of the pro class, but just he's a guy you just want to see do well. Just a stand-up individual, a hell of an athlete. He came so close to qualifying for the non-adaptive class last year, narrowly missed it just again this year. So big things ahead for him, but the guy's just blazing a trail in this class.
Yeah.
And that's so awesome to see him.
Mm-hmm. So just to recap our top 1 through 3, these are the favorites: Cody, Cowboy, Jesse Kirschmeyer, Brock Hoyer. So far this year, Cody has 5 snowcross wins and so does Jesse. They're even. So, you know, Jesse had a mechanical that prevented him from a good result, so who knows how that would have gone. But, you know, they're both looking good this year. They have confidence. Brock raced Canterbury. He had a win. And then he had a second the second day. So, you know, that's pretty cool for him. And, you know, they're putting in the effort. They all know what's on the line here. And, you know, I know them all. They're pretty passionate about stuff. So it's good for them to, you know, compete with each other, and after the fact, they'll all be friends again.
Absolutely. And others we would definitely want to mention. Yannick, Harris, Heisinga, Darren Meese, Seth Fisher, Josh Hill, Colton, Davis, Mark Wilson, Mick Olson. Starting out with Yannick, lots of seconds and thirds.
Yes.
The guy's been pretty dominant up mm-hmm. in Canada, that's for sure.
He won last year.
Circuit. Mm-hmm. He has this quiet confidence about him.
Yeah, he's a pretty quiet guy, but really, like, he trains hard, and a few weeks ago I went out to ERX with Jesse, and he was there, and they were battling. So, like, you know, if he gets a good start, he'll be up there. You know, if anyone can break into that top three, I think it's either him or Josh Hill. They're pretty solid, and they've both, you know, been working their butts off to get to where they are. Last year he had a DNF at ERX. I believe he suffered an injury in this. So that kind of prevented him from obviously doing well, but it'll be interesting to see this year. I hope he gets through healthy, and, you know, it'll be interesting to see if he can break into that top three, get a medal for Team Yeti Snow MX.
So, this would be a bit of a redemption round for him. He's able to break into that top three. And speaking of coming back from injury, if I'm not mistaken, wasn't it Harris we saw had an incident on track last year in Michigan?
Yes.
He did.
Yeah, he crashed. I believe he broke his arm.
Mm-hmm.
So it's good for him to come back and have a solid third place finish in the first qualifier at ERX. You know, he got in right away. He didn't have to deal with any, you know, drama in going through a second qualifier or an LCQ or anything like that. So good for him to get in right away. That was his first attempt at qualifying for X Games because, unfortunately, the Fargo Snowcross round overlapped with the first qualifier. So ERX was the second, and it had a little, you know, some heavy hitters there that missed it the first weekend. So I think Harris will be someone to contend with. He's always been fast. He's always also a very quiet guy. And, you know, again, I think he'll do well if he gets a good start.
Absolutely. Mark Wilson finished up second in the championship last year in Amsoil Championship Snowcross. And that one kind of came down to the wire, if I'm not mistaken, through, like, beginning of Lake Geneva, like, Dubuque. I remember catching up with him. Mm-hmm. It was close. And I don't think it was a, I don't want to say it was a specific injury, but things had happened towards the end of the season. He wasn't feeling 100%, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah, he broke his foot.
Was that that's what? It, mm-hmm. Okay, but he pushed through it, and that's why in my mind I'm thinking.
No, he didn't tell anybody. He tried to keep it a secret. Mm-hmm. You know, just as I don't want anyone to know, kind of a thing. Mm-hmm. I don't want anyone to think I'm weak.
Mission accomplished.
Yep. Mm-hmm. You didn't remember. Mm-hmm. He's a secret keeper, but you know he pushed through that and he finished second overall. So that. Really good for him. He's a very fun, lighthearted guy. So, you know, from what I hear, he's doing all right out there today in practice, warming up to it. So, like, if guys like Mark aren't feeling 100% on this track at X Games, it's gnarly. Like, he can race the toughest snowcross tracks, and if he's not feeling it, no one's feeling it. Like, it's, you gotta be crazy to figure out this wild X Games track apparently this year.
Colton, let's talk about Colton Davis. Yeah. He's had a tough go at the qualifiers.
Yes. He, in the second final at ERX, there was some chaos and he got pushed off the track. And from what the officials deemed, he had cut the track, so they gave him the black furled flag, and he dropped back three positions. So I think, you know, he was out front, he was leading, he was feeling good, and then had to drop back those three positions. You know, I think that was kind of unfortunate for him, and then he had a fall, and that really, you know, that can discourage a rider, of course. Mm-hmm. So I'm glad to see that he got an invite. And I think he'll do good. You know, he has what it takes. It's just putting it all together. And, you know, I believe in the kid. He's a good kid. And he's loving Colorado.
Badass. Josh Hill. Yes. When goes out and wins the first qualifier at ERX.
Yes. Oh, my gosh. Okay, so last year, Josh Hill had not even practiced on a snow bike. The year prior, he raced the AMA snow bike series. And I don't remember how he did, but he's Josh Hill. He's fast. Mm-hmm. Like, this guy used to win supercross races. So last year he hadn't really prepped much. This year he's been prepping. He's been riding snow bikes. He's been riding hill climbs. He's been riding supercross. He's racing East Supercross Series for the Club MX team. Like, he's on it. He's in shape. He's into it. And he was fast. Mm-hmm. Really, like, of the people that can break into that top podium positions, it's going to be Josh. Josh is going to be one of them. Really, like, if he gets a good start, he'll be gone. And, you know, I keep going back to this, and it feels like every single race, it's like, oh, they got a good start. Mm-hmm. But really, like, that's important when all these guys are very similar in speed.
Yep.
And there's not a whole lot to separate them, but maybe this X Games track is wild enough. Mm-hmm. To separate them. So I guess we'll see tomorrow and see how that pans out. But, you know, I think Josh will do really well.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. Seth, he wins the first qualifier in Snowmass by 15 seconds. And we touched on this a little bit. But fifth last year. Mm-hmm. I'm feeling really good about this guy.
Yeah, I do too. From what I hear, he's feeling good. So, like, you know, if you can tell the guy's on, the guy's on. Mm-hmm. Like, I'm excited to see it. He's a hometown friend of mine. So, you know, it'll be good for Minnesota to have someone doing so well at X Games. So yeah. That was pretty cool. And he's been at every single snow bike cross at X Games. He's been to every single one of them. This is his fourth, I believe. Yeah. So okay. It's, which is cool, you know, and not something that a lot of people know about him, that he's a four-time X Games athlete. Like, that's pretty cool. So, you know, we hope the best for him and see what he'll come out with.
Darren Meese seems a bit frustrated by the fact that he's just narrowly missed the podium mm-hmm. the last 2 years.
Yes.
That's got to leave him so hungry.
Yes.
You know?
Yes. Yeah. He finished fourth at X Games the past 2 years. You know, and I think from what he's told me, that's a big reason why he has switched to Yeti. You know, he felt that Yeti was the best choice for him. And we'll see how it pans out.
What about that Mick Olson?
Yeah.
He didn't make the final last year at X, but second in the second qualifier at X.
Yeah. So Mick is also another very quiet guy. So it is interesting to see, you know, what his prep is like. He's a new dad. They have a super cute baby. And so he wasn't unable to come race Canterbury. I saw him posting about, like, oh, I wish I could be there kind of stuff. But I think he'll do well, too. You know, it'll be interesting. You know, it's tough. Like, one mistake, because they don't just qualify based on times. They qualify based on racing, based on rounds, heats. So, you know, if you get a bad start or if you fall in your heat, you're kind of screwed, no matter how fast you really are and how you qualify. So I kind of like that format of racing to get to your spot, qualifying mm-hmm. based on times, but then racing to get to your spot. You know, that'll weed out the people who get nervous or the people who get weird when they're nervous, so, or, you know, just out of control kind of things. So back to Mick, like, I think, you know, I think he'll do well. I think he can keep a level head and, you know, move forward. And hopefully he gets a shot to really showcase what he's got because he is fast.
Mm. And I think that level head is going to be huge because half the battle, and all depending on the track, is staying upright.
Yes.
And then that's 50% of the battle. The other 50 is you know, being part of the race that's going on. So I think that's gonna serve him well, no doubt.
Yeah. So those are our kind of top 10 guys. They at X Games, they invite 20 athletes to come compete. And through those rounds, through those heats, they select 12 people qualify for the final. So, you know, you got the 20 best snow bike athletes in the world, and only 12 of those guys get a shot at gold. You know, so it's really hard. It's really, really hard for them to even get into that final and do decent. So we've talked about our heavy hitters, and I think we're going to move into, you know, the rest of the gang and who can be surprising. Mm-hmm. So I like to take a look at the kids. They're literally minors. You know, Parker Earl, he's 17 years old. He got second in the first qualifier in Snowmass. The kid's fast, and he is super fast on dirt bikes, very naturally talented. You know, we'll see what he's got. Like, very young riders are very fast, but they can lack the racing experience that Josh Hill has, and knowing what to do in certain situations and things like that. So, you know, that could maybe be against him, but, you know, he is fast, so he could turn it up and qualify and get right into that final. You never know. The second kid is Troy Horvath. He's a Canadian native, and he got second in the second qualifier in Snowmass, so the Sunday, the second day of racing. you know, that gets fast too. He throws whips. You know, like, it's something you've never seen on dirt bike. Him and Yannick throw the, like, awesome whips, which are just, you know, you don't think about whipping a snow bike that weighs way more than a dirt bike. It's like,
it's a beautiful thing, though. It's,
oh my god, it's so cool. The picture is so cool. So, you know, we wish the best for Troy, and, like, really, you know, he can do well if he gets his head on straight. But, you know, just being so young, he can be susceptible to, you know, just the atmosphere of X Games and how, you know, not so much pressure that there is, but maybe pressure that he puts on himself and, you know, that he shouldn't, and just believe in himself kind of a thing.
For sure.
So, also Tommy Thompson, this is his first X Games qualification. He got third in the second qualifier at ERX, and they're from Washington, so not somewhere where there's a lot of racing. So it's pretty cool to see how natural he is on the racing circuit. He's been racing some of the NASPA and AMA series, but that's nothing really like what we have been racing in the snow bike cross series or the snow cross series. So, you know, it's good to see how quickly the kids take into these types of tracks and how fast that he really goes. So, yeah, moving on to Justin Thomas. He won the second qualifier in SoMass by 7 seconds, which is not Seth Fisher's 15 seconds, but it's still, like, still. 7 seconds on a 45-second track, 45-second lap time track is still very impressive. You know, he looked good. I think he had a crash on Saturday that prevented him from doing super well in the first qualifier, but he was looking good. Like, I remember watching him. I was just, like, very impressed. I would be surprised to see how he does. You know, last year, I don't know if he really, I think he and his brother came out just to, like, give it a shot, and then he made it, and he was invited, so now I think it's a little more serious for him, and, you know, we'll see how his qualification goes.
Well, onto our final picks and predictions. I don't know if you want to spell it out, like, in no particular order, but, you know, maybe your top three, who you're expecting a standout performance from.
I'm going to turn it back to you. What do you think? You're as a fan.
Oh, is this strictly a fan perspective? You know,
yeah, as a fan.
As media, we don't get to have an opinion.
No.
But I do have one. it's in there. and this is just a piggyback off of what we had said. I think it's no secret that Cody Matichuk, he has the track record here to do very well. He's poised to do very well. He looked great in practice. And just seeing how he's done also on the Amswell Snowcross circuit, I think he'd be a strong pick for a podium finish. You know, we had talked about Showtime, and that today may not have been, you know, the best depiction of what he's capable of, and I take that with a big grain of salt, because, you know what, he has 24 hours from that practice session to, you know, turn things around in his head, figure out what he needs to do, and they call him Showtime for a reason, so expecting big things from him. You know, Brock Hoyer, he's gonna be tough, but I know how much Darren Mees wants this. And this is where it gets so, so tricky for me.
Because they're all so close in speed.
They are.
It really, last year, Cody made his way up through the pack, and everyone has gotten so much better than them. I don't know, if you get a good start, if you'll be able to just plow through the field.
Mm-hmm.
You know, like, everyone has gotten so good. Like, they're not just going to let you pass. They all want it now.
Mm-hmm.
You know, there's respect, but also, like, there's a desire to win, to podium.
Mm-hmm.
So,
and just, you know, considering the track record of past years and what they've shown as of recent, Mick Olson, Seth Fisher, I'm expecting something to happen there.
Mm-hmm. I hope something.
What is going to happen? I don't know, but I'm expecting something there. So I guess, You know, expect the unexpected. The sport's evolving year after year. But just from what I've seen as of recent, and of course from last year, I guess that's what I'm watching for, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah. What about you?
You know, Cody is the easy favorite. I don't think it's going to be easy. You know, it's a lot of pressure on yourself to expect a third gold medal in a row. But, you know, I know he works his butt off, and he is very naturally good at this. So I don't know. I expect it. But like I said before, like, if he gets a bad start, kind of like he did last year, it might not be as easy as it was last year. Mm-hmm. So the guy's wild. The guy's sandy. And on a track like this that is wild and sandy, you know, it might just be perfect for him. And if he can get out front early, I think he can pull away. But also, like we were talking about a little bit, Showtime, he knows how to turn it on for Showtime. You know, practice is one thing. Practice doesn't really matter. You know, practice doesn't matter.
It means nothing.
No. And when it's time to perform, it's time to perform. And I think that he can do that too. So it would be very cool for him to upset Cody and upset his streak. So I guess we'll see. And, you know, I'm going to go with Seth Fisher for that third place spot. He was a very solid... Maybe I pick Josh Hill. Josh is just so much more prepared this year, and he's so naturally good. Okay, I'm gonna pick four. Yeah. He's just so naturally good that... Like, his preparation can make such a big difference. Mm-hmm. So him and Seth, and if Seth is feeling good, like we hear that he's feeling, you know, that can be a huge confidence booster for him today into tomorrow. So I guess I'm picking top four, you know, out of those four. Well, three of them will be podium. No promises. Don't hold us to it. Yeah. Should we move on to the adaptive class?
Let's move on. I think there are many stories to be told here. We've good talked ones. About Mike Schultz, the people's yes. champ, as I'm going to dub him. But Tyler Brandenburger last year, silver.
Yeah, I know. Very quiet silver. He won both qualifiers this year in the adaptive class. So, you know, good for him. He has a great sense of humor. He jokes about... he lost a leg, and he jokes about losing his leg. I made some Yeti cookies for all of the Yeti athletes, and he goes, "Yeah, can you break off my leg, my Yeti's leg?" I was like, "What?" He's like, "Yeah, you know, I lost a leg. My Yeti should lose a leg too," kind of a thing. I'm like, "Okay, sure." I did not. But you know, the guy is awesome and really has a very positive attitude and outlook on life. So. You know, I think it'll be very tough to upset Mike Schultz, especially if he's getting sendier than the Pro X class. But Tyler is very solid, and anything can happen in racing. You know, if you get sendy, you can crash. That's the thing. So who knows? I expect another podium for sure out of Tyler.
For sure. And I was, you know, this is back in time, rewind. I was able to be a part of the X Games qualifier at ERX last December, so 2018, and a couple standout performances I saw there. Now, given some time has passed, but Pablo Jimenez, he was had a very strong showing, but also Will Posey.
Yes. That's para.
Yeah.
They separated the two classes by now. Yeah. So at that time, yes, they were the same class. But since then, they've separated the two, which is super awesome for the sport, you know? Like, now we have the opportunity for all of these people to earn a medal. Like, that's super cool. But nothing for the women's class.
We'll get there.
That might need to be its own podcast. Because it might be lengthy. But, you know, Pablo is a racer. You know, he's like trying to block Colleen at the qualifiers and stuff, and Colleen's like, "You gotta stop doing that." It's like, he's like, "No, I'm just blocking you." She's like, "No, you're sketchy." And they go back and forth, but they're friends, you know. So it's pretty good. It's pretty funny. Good banter. You know, it's easy for people to overlook these adaptive impair classes because it's not the pro class, but they provide just as good a racing. It's super awesome to watch these people race and how determined they are to win too. And it's so cool for them to have the opportunity to showcase their talents.
For sure. And there's a lot of talent at that. Yeah. No doubt.
Yeah. So we'll move into para. Will has only been paralyzed for 2 years. Mm-hmm. Like, last year when he competed at X Games was, like, his one-year anniversary of being paralyzed. Yeah. Which is crazy to me just to see how far he has come as a person. Mm-hmm. You know, like, I can't imagine. I feel like I would just not want to ride ever again. But he's gotten adapted to how he is now. And it's cool. He rips. He's like, we're like the same speed. Like, I'm like, dude, you're getting sendy. He's like, no, you're getting sendy. Like, okay, we're getting sendy.
And, you know, it hasn't been without its challenges for him, I'm sure. I can only imagine what that process has been like. You know, he's, like you said, hasn't been paralyzed for all that long, but he didn't spend much time, much downtime. He got right back into it, which is
probably good, really amazing. Good for him, I bet. Mm-hmm. His point to me was, like, Doug Henry won last year. And he was like, well, think about, like, how long Doug's been riding as a paralyzed person and how long I've been riding like this. You know, so it's just very different to see how quickly he's adapted. And I think he's very hungry for gold this year. He really wants it. So, you know, nothing gonna stop him.
The moto legend.
Doug Henry.
And speaking of a couple of snowmobile legends, Blair Morgan, Paul Thacker.
Mm-hmm. I know. Like, the para class has a lot of heavy hitters, big names in it, you know? So it's cool that these racers now have an outlet. You know, they don't just have to race side-by-sides or whatever. They can still ride motorcycles, which is pretty cool. Like, a snow bike stands up by itself. Like, if they figure out how to balance, they're just fine. Mm-hmm. They can hit the big jumps still. Like, it's nuts to me. But it's so cool. It's so cool. Like, Doug Henry is a 3-time motocross champion and a 1-time supercross champion. And he's in the AMA Hall of Fame. And we have him in our tiny sport. Like, we convinced him to race snow bikes, which is amazing. You know, which is what we need to bring our sport, you know, to the general public or to the motocross racers, you know, that are like, well, what is this? Oh, Doug Henry's racing snow bikes? Like, okay, maybe I'm interested, kind of a thing. Same with Paul Thacker and Blair Morgan. Like, the snowmobile community is just as important as the motocross community in this because the whole snow bike, you know, movement is a mixture of the two. So if you can get people from both sides, you're doing pretty good. You're dipping into two pools of interest, which is really, really good for the sport.
Absolutely. Two very influential names and just two household names in motorsports and in snow sports in particular. So, like I said, we're very, very lucky to have them here on the snow bike side. That's for sure.
Yeah. Well, I think that's our coverage.
I think that's it. Now it's just on to X Games.
On to X Games.
Today. In a few hours.
1:41 a.m. Mountain time.
It's time for a sleep because we have racing ourselves to do tomorrow. Well, you do.
I have racing.
I'll be flapping my gums.
She's just going to talk all day and go downtown and dress up like an old-timey person.
That is going to happen. Some old-time photos for myself in the CBS Sports Network crew here at the U.S. Air Force Snowcross National. I can't wait.
Honored. Thanks for listening this long. If you made it this long, we appreciate your support. Like us and follow us and, you know, do all the things on the Facebook, on the Instagram, at Minne Moto Show. And we'll see you guys in a couple days for our X Games review. We'll see what happens. I wanna see some naked dudes.